Just take what you want and go. Jackpot.
Fuck!
Now what?
I'll tell you now what. Come here.
What?
Oh, shit.
Get up.
So long, Johnny.
You fucking bastard. I'm gonna fucking kill you, Aldridge.
Maybe. Maybe not.
Fuck! We got company.
None of you are getting out of here alive.
Motherfuckers over here!
Get
this dog fucker off me!
Gotta be a key card around here somewhere.
Check the desks, the bodies, everywhere. God damn it.
Don't let me die
Come
like
on.
This.
Come on, open, god damn it. Motherfuck!
On the car.
Get this door open. God damn it!
What'd he take?
Surveillance photos, satellite imagery, and asset files from anyone who's come into the country from Cuba over the last 10 years. Fuck!
What the hell's this guy after? You know something.
I've had my suspicions ever since Chucky said he overheard Aldridge talking about a plane. Balmana and his crew were piloting a plane out of Havana, but they weren't looking to defect. They were returning something that didn't belong to them. The CIA codenamed the incident Dvochka, which in Russian means little girl or commie princess or some goddamn thing. Anyway, the plane's cargo was part of a Russian R-12 theater ballistic missile.
Which part are we talking about?
The thermonuclear warhead part.
Well, this shit just got a hell of a lot more interesting.
A storm took the plane down mid-flight. Balmana and his crew bailed. After 12 months of searching, the CIA considered Dvochka lost at sea. Nothing to be done about it.
Unless it wasn't lost at sea.
Unless, right, unless it wasn't. If Aldridge gets his hands on this, there's no telling what he'll do.
All right. So if Aldridge took the files and surveillance photos to track this thing down,
then we need another way to find it. What about Balmana's crew?
If we could track down another one of the assholes that was on that flight, they may be able to tell us what we need to know. The mainframe's connected to a network that should allow us to patch in and access Balmana's files. Okay. We got it.
It was a four-man crew on the plane.
Uh-huh.
Two of them managed to make it back to Havana. But Balmana and a man by the name of Ruben Paez came to the States.
Where's Paez now?
Looks like the CIA got him a job as a janitor at a department store in Frisco Fields.
There's no way Aldridge leaves a loose end like that kicking around. The poor bastard's on his way out. He doesn't even know it.
Then I guess we better get to Paez before Aldridge does.
This man, Connor Aldridge. When did you first meet him?
June 1954. We went into Guatemala as part of PB Success, and then we went our separate ways and ran into each other again in Vietnam.
Well, according to these reports, Mr. Aldridge was very successful in infiltrating the NVA. So successful, in fact, he cultivated several contacts that became double agents.
That's one way of putting it.
And how would you put it?
Let's just say you shouldn't believe everything you read. I can type up some bullshit on fancy letterhead, doesn't change the fact that it's bullshit.
Mr. Donovan, did you or did you not have contact with Connor Aldridge in the summer of 1968 in New Bordeaux?
That cocksucker died in an alleyway in Saigon. I'm done talking about him.
I need to call this into Langley. Meet me in the French ward, and we'll track down Paez.